so it turns out the trend is actually global. It's not just about college mental health, and it's not just the United States. Now, these numbers are likely underestimates because it's actually very challenging to count people with mental illness around the world. So about 322 million people are estimated to have depression. That's about the same number of people as live in the United States. That's up 18% in roughly the past decade, and now the number one cause of disability in the world. 800,000 people die per year from suicide, and that number, and that's now the number two cause of death among young people worldwide. Anxiety disorders also up about 18% in roughly the past decade. And dementia, the numbers are expected to triple by 2050. Why? Why is this happening? What is driving these trends in colleges and all around the world? Do we know anything about the root causes? So that is there anything we can do about this, or is this just how it's supposed to be? Well, there are some theories that have been around a long time about what causes these mental health problems. The neurotransmitter deficit theory, stress, trauma, and of course your mother. So what about this modern atrocity? Might this have a little something to do with it? You know, we have learned the hard way, as many other speakers have just told you, about how dangerous this diet is, this modern diet, for our physical health. So it stands to reason, you know, why should the brain be any different?